To the 22nd session of the Inter-Society Weekly Webinar Series. Thank you all for joining today. We are now going to have a great session by Dr. Devin Prabhakar from iCare, Tips to Ensure Good Sight Throughout Your Life. It's a very important topic for each one of us. Before we go on to the session, a few ground rules. Request all participants to ensure that the microphone is always remain muted. And request, except for the speakers, all others to kindly turn off their videos so as to conserve bandwidth. If you have any questions, request you to type in the chat box so that we can take it up during the question and answer session at the end. Any technical issues also may please be noted in the chat window. Now, I request for the welcome session, a welcome address by Mr. Suhair. Thank you.
Okay, good evening and good morning and good afternoon, depending on where you are. It's my pleasant privilege to welcome you all, and Dr. Devin Prabhakar in particular, to the 22nd webinar organized under the patronage of 7 prominent professional organizations. Institution of Engineers Kerala Center, IEEE Kerala Section, EMBS Kerala, Internet Society, Project Management Institute, Computer Society of India, and Vakkam Madhavi Foundation. This program has been gaining immense popularity as witnessed by the large number of registrations from several countries, the diversity of topics, and the eminence of speakers. We had well-known technologists, engineers, economists, medical professionals, environmentalists, scientists, educationists, mass leaders, but talking to us in the past. Congratulations to Ajay Harindalal for efficiently coordinating and delivering a very enjoyable program. Today, we have Dr. Devin Prabhakar of Divya Prabha Eye Hospital, a well-known eminent ophthalmologist, talking to us on eye care, tips to ensure good sight throughout your life. No need to tell the importance and value of eyesight. We say, Nam kannile krishnamani pole kaathukollam, that is the ultimate. Nothing beyond that in taking care. A large part of the brain is dedicated to the visual processing. 80% of what we perceive comes through eyes. It's an amazing organ with 2 million working parts. Okay, anagilum, eyesight, we take it for granted. We are not paying the attention care required. So Dr. Devin will tell us in no uncompromising words how to guard and preserve this valuable treasure. Before the talk, the speaker will be introduced by Mr. Balagopal. Over to you, Balagopal. Thank you.
Good evening, sir. So we are starting for a good subject. It is required for every public. And the assignment which has been given to me is to introduce a famous ophthalmologist who knows all the people in Kerala and also abroad. I think it is a privilege for me to introduce Dr. Devin Prabhakar at this time. Thankful to the organizers of this program for giving me the opportunity for attending and participating in the webinar like this, and also get an opportunity to introduce an eminent doctor. So let me come to the point, because no need of wasting the time. The time is precious for knowing the valuable information about how to protect eyes throughout the life. So I'm coming to the fact that let me introduce some facts about which I know for the last few years. I met him a few years back during the time, I think it is in 2013, I think so. That is the year Dr. Devin was elected as the best doctor in the private sector for the Kerala government. So you may know that the rare opportunity which may get an younger doctor, this kind of appreciation, acceptance. I don't find anything unusual or anything above what has happened, because he deserves such awards, because he is the person fully dedicated for serving the people. After meeting him at this time, I had many occasions, because you may not be knowing that I am also an office bearer of Lions Clubs International. For that, many activities are coming up, and we are mobilizing many activities for the social requirement of the public. In connection with that, whatever the needs which we require to educate the people or give some assistance to the people, any assistance which needs regarding the eye care, Dr. Devin, I used to find that he takes more initiative to take any responsibility, not only by physical presence, not only be giving the educating the public, and also financially or whatever the possible way that he can do, he associate with the activities, whatever the Alliance Clubs or whoever it may be, because people know that he is associating with many organizations. If you go into that particular subject, we can see that all the organizations are service-oriented organizations. That means this shows his passion towards the service to the public. Really, that is the minute point which I came close together with Dr. David. That is the main reason. So after that, the first event which had happened in that time was glaucoma awareness. For that, we had done a beautiful procession and propaganda program, which started from Kavadiyar and closed at Vellayambalam, where so many people crowd, and high coverage in media also could achieve due to the high initiative of this Dr. Prabhakar. What I mean, considering the precautions, what all to be taken, prevention and the caring, eye caring, he is doing a lot to the public. That is the real fact, the reason why the government also considered as a best doctor in the private sector, considering the ophthalmology. I think I'm not in the wrong way saying that He is maybe the first person or the only one person who might have got this award. As at that age, hope you know, the government declares these awards for the recognition as the best doctor award. Normally it gives to the people above 50 or 55, because you know, at that time only he gets that much of experience in the public as a best doctor, and everybody knows that he is a doctor and he is the best doctor. But even at the earlier, I think it is 40, 45, he attained this. That itself is an additional feather to his credit. So whether to say what the experience is, the quality, how he gained is that. I think it is the experience, and that too from international experience we cannot neglect, because he has got a lot of experience from foreign countries. He is a recipient of not only this Best Doctor Award, and many awards he had got it. He is a visiting consultant in Maldives, and many times he goes to Maldives and do the consultation there. And he had taken the FRCS from UK. Likewise, the experience, the vast experience in this field, that is the high level plannings and other activities which he is doing in this public. Moreover, which I have to say, see, every moment, every day, every hour, every moment, there is a changes are taking place. So anyone who deals with any subject, whatever may be the doctor field, engineering field, any other field, should be aware or be eager to know what is happening every moment, what is the changes is happening in the field, in the society. So unless we watch the changes that is happening in the society, we will not be able to monitor, and we will not be able to take the measuring of the taking the precautions, whatever it may, what is required, we will not be able to get it. So where we can find Dr. Devin Prabhakar is a person who thinks every time, whatever be the changes happening in the society, that means now also I can say an example. This COVID has come. Even then at that time, and even before also, many times I had to could see that he looks into the things which is what all changes happening. He changes his own attitude, his own dealings, whatever it may be, according to the changes, what is required for his profession. So that is the high quality which I could see him, because we should go along with the changes. We should find the changes, what is happening, and what the changes it is happened, we have to mold our own strategies according to the service, what is required to the society. That is the essential thing that is required of any human being which is serving the public. So that is definitely 100% he is doing it in all the things which is in all the activities. About that, recently,
Balagopal, can we hand over to Ms. Dr. Devin, sir, because we are running short of time, sir.
Okay, let me conclude. So he's the just for one moment, maybe. He's a son of Dr. N. Prabhakaran and also Dr. Sushila Prabhakaran, and his wife is Dr. Kavita Devin. The family is also doctor's family. All the things which are doing, he's dedicated his life for serving the people. Thank you. Let me have the thank all of them for giving me a chance to brief Dr. Devin. Thank you.
Dr. Devin, sir, please.
Right, ma'am. Thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity. And Balagopal, sir, for the very kind words, and to the organizers for having me here. I'll start my screen share, and I promise to keep it within 45 minutes. I will stay within time. And this is my first slide. Let me just start from beginning. So what we're talking on will be eye care to ensure good sight throughout your life. I think this is very important. We start off with our philosophy. Sarvendriyanam Nayanam Pradhanam. Among the five senses, eye is the most important. And this talk will be dedicated to preserving sight, how we can ensure we have good sight even during these trying times. And I'm extremely grateful to Harindra sir and to all the organizers. It's the first time I'm coming to a joint meeting of seven wonderful organizations, all of them which are quite famous all over India. And I think they are doing international work goals. It's really a proud privilege. And this is what I'll be talking on. Now, in this present time, we cannot do a talk on health without talking on, without touching on COVID. The question I ask is, does COVID pass through the eyes? Does it spread through the tears, which is very important? And second, something we are all doing now, computers. How does it affect the eyes? Tips on tricks, how you can protect your eyes when you're using computers for a long time. Then we'll go on to warning signs and teleophthalmology, how we can use Zoom or even WhatsApp to get eye care. And then last part, which I have not done a talk on this topic so far, is looking good in a Zoom call, an ophthalmologist perspective. I think this is based on a lot of preparation that I did, and I hope you'll find it useful. Just directly go on to the talk. And this is about conjunctivitis in COVID-19 patients. Now, usually, we all know 80% of COVID patients are asymptomatic. They don't have any symptoms. But very rarely, a conjunctivitis patient might harbor COVID. But you do not need to worry that anybody you are seeing with a red eye, he could be probably having COVID, because it's very rare. It is only seen in 1 to 3% of people with COVID. And fortunately, this conjunctivitis that you see is usually seen in the middle part of the disease. That means the COVID or the corona infection does not start as a conjunctivitis infection. The patient develops it as he develops fever also. So the chance that a patient who comes to an ophthalmology OP transmitting it to another doctor or to the staff or to the bystander is very rare. So that is one reassurance that I can give you, that it is safe to go to an ophthal hospital during this time for a routine eye checkup. I'll be coming to what all precautions the eye hospital will be taking on our part, and what all precautions the patient and the bystander should take when they visit a hospital. Now, if you talk about conjunctivitis per se, the treatment of a conjunctivitis due to COVID is nothing special. We just treat it with lubricant eye drops and the usual antibiotic drops. Now, what happens in our land is that whenever we hear something like this, we start self-medication. Whether it is Ayurveda, homeopathy, or anything else, I have nothing against any other specialty. I am all for taking good, healthy food, yoga, meditation. We all do that. But sometimes we overdo things. Now, we know conjunctivitis could be a symptom of COVID. So what do we usually start doing? We wash our eyes with a lot of water. As you can see in this photo, some people just open their eyes and stand in below the shower and keep their eyes open, wanting to wash out all the bacteria, even the coronavirus. So this is not good. What happens is, when you wash your eyes with lots of water, it washes away whatever good things are in the tears. The tear has got mucus, it has got lipids, it has got protective antimicrobial elements also. So if you wash your eyes frequently, all these gets washed out. And whatever problems are there in the water, like chlorine or other impurities, get into the eye and actually can cause harm. So first take-home message is, don't wash your eyes frequently. After waking up from sleep, when you brush your teeth, nicely wash your face. Maybe after your lunchtime, wash your face again, but not every half an hour or very, very often. Now, this is what most people go to an ophthalmologist for. They go to an ophthalmologist for getting a spectacle done. So I get a lot of calls from my patients, from my relatives, from my friends. Is it safe to come and meet you? Or should I wait till the COVID is over before getting my eyeglasses done? Now, a glass is a routine thing, so there's no harm in waiting. If you are seeing reasonably, you don't need to change your glasses. There's no harm in waiting for a few months. But let us see, if you want to get your spectacle done, what are the things that we take care? When I say we, I'm not specifically talking about Divya Prabhai Hospital or my practice. I'm talking about ophthalmologists all over the world. Because we are all guided by our association. We have got the All India Ophthalmic Society. We are the Kerala State Ophthalmic Society. We have got the American Academy of Ophthalmology. All these big associations come out with guidelines that ophthalmologists like me, eye hospitals like me follow to ensure that the patients who come to us anywhere in the world are safe. Now, what we do is we give a face shield, as can be seen in this photo. We give a face shield that goes over the face. Behind that, we have an N95 mask so that the person who checks the spectacle, he does not breathe corona onto the patient's face. And secondly, the patient also wears a mask so that his breath does not go to the optometrist. Now, what we need to remember is that even normal breathing, normal speaking, especially if you're angry, if you speak loud, the chance of corona transmission is more. So when you get your eyeglasses checked, remember not to speak too much. Maybe you can say it is good, it is bad, this is not correct, or it is perfect. So you can use eye signs and try to be as speedy as possible. Then in our hospital and in all hospitals, once a patient has put on a trial frame, once it is removed from the patient, we keep it in a UV sterilizer. Some hospitals clean it with absolute alcohol. Some people use chloral hydrate. We clean it and then only we reuse it for the next patient, so it is safe. And then another thing that we do is we give a paper for the patient to read. Instead of using a paper, you can use your own mobile phone while it is checked so that the safety is much better. So regarding spectacle checkup to ensure good sight. And this is one more slide on spectacles. So you have gone to a doctor, you need to change your spectacles, or your specs is broken, you need to change your specs. So how do you ensure that when you go to an optical shop that you are not getting infected with COVID at that time? So try to minimize the number of frames you put on your face. Once you put on a frame, all eye clinics, all eye optical shops, they put it in a red plastic box. Now, before it is kept back into the straw, this is wiped with a sanitizer so that it is free of bacteria, fungus, and of course the coronavirus. And the face shield is compulsory for the staff. The patient should wear a mask. If he wants to remove the mask and look at the mirror, he can do that, he can go 1 meter away from the staff, remove his mask, take a selfie and see if it is comfortable. Or you can even do an online trial with the frames. Now, one complaint that a lot of people tell at the optical shop is that the delay in getting the frame done. Even my hospital, one or two patients even complained on Google that there's a delay in getting the specs done. That is true because there's a supply chain disruption all over the world. Now, as you know, China was and is the manufacturing hub of the world. Most of the frames are made in China, so getting frames is becoming a little difficult. Some of the lenses are made in China, so the supply chain disruption is having an effect in optical industry, also as all over the world. So you can expect a slight delay when you go and get a glasses done from an optical shop. Now, next question that a lot of people ask an ophthalmologist is, when you get your glasses done, should we go for an anti-reflection coating? The second question many people ask is, doctor, I'm using Zoom for a long time, or my son is studying on computer for a long time. Should he buy a glass with anti-reflection coating or a computer glass as it is called? Now, if you look at what it is said, it is anti-reflection coating. So when you wear a glass, it has a reflection from its surface. So I'm going to wear a glass now. When I'm wearing this glass, what you see is not my eyes. What you're seeing is reflection from the glass. So when light reflects from the glass, you cannot see my eyes clearly. And so my expression, the way I transmit information, my feelings, emotions are not transmitted correctly. So if this glass is not having an anti-reflection coating, if I wear a glass with anti-reflection coating, the whole light will enter my eye. You will be able to see my eye clearly as the photo that went below. The lady, you can see one eye is very clear because that lens has got an anti-reflection coating. While the other lens, you cannot see the eye because light is reflecting off the surface. So the thing is, if you wear glasses, it is better to use glasses with anti-reflection coating, because that will give you clearer vision and people who see you will be able to see your eyes better. The second part of the question is, if you don't require glasses, there is no point in getting a computer glass done, because without glasses, there is no reflection, so you don't need anti-reflection. So obviously, for a person who does not need glasses, wearing a glass while you look at computer does not in any way help. I think that is a question many people have in their mind. I hope I have cleared that sufficiently, and we'll go forward. Now, this is a slide that I prepared for a program that I did for school children on what they should use for studying. Is it a tablet? Is it a mobile? Is it a laptop? Is it a computer? Now, very basically, at a very simple level, if you look at it, bigger the screen, the more comfortable the child will be. So better than a mobile would be a tablet. Better than a tablet would be a laptop. Better than a laptop would be a computer, because as the screen size increases, our strain decreases. But one thing I want to add at this point, not all of us are very well off. For a family, maybe the husband has lost his job during this COVID time. Some, they may be on a pay cut. They might have two children. Buying two laptops may not be within the reach of a lot of people. Nothing to worry. Studying on a mobile phone will be okay. No need to, stress yourself out, take a loan to buy a large TV or a computer. If it is there, well and good. But even with a mobile phone, with a few tips that I'll be giving study on a mobile or a laptop. So if you're using a mobile, hold it at the arm's length so that you are at a comfortable distance, so that your eye does not strain out fast. Similarly for a mobile phone, similarly for a tablet also. And for the TV, we need to sit at least 6 feet away from the TV. Now, some tips on adjusting the TV, the laptop, and the mobile. When you sit in a room, it should be lit like this. That means if you sit in a very dark room and you have a mobile in your hand, what happens is, because only a small part of your retina is being illuminated by the light and the rest of the retina is dark, it can cause a lot of strain. So you need to have adequate light in the room. Point number one. Point number two, the brightness of the screen should be little more than the brightness in the room. So don't keep your brightness very high. It should be more than the brightness in the room, but not very high. And to increase the clarity, you can increase the contrast. Now we are talking about two things. One is brightness and two is contrast. Brightness is how bright the thing is, and contrast is relation between black and gray. So when you increase the contrast, you increase the gradations and you can see clearly. So point number one, have a little light in the room, brightness as much as you require, not more. Contrast as much as possible and as big a screen as possible. And avoid reflections. Now, when you look at this TV, you can see that it is just opposite to a window. And what you see is a bright window reflection. And next, what you see is the tube light reflecting off the screen. These two can cause a lot of interference with your clarity. So make sure that light does not fall directly on the screen. Ideally, light should be at the sides. Now, this is what you get. You can buy from Amazon. It is called a backlight. Basically, what you do is, if this is your TV, you can stick LED strip lights behind the TV so that you get a diffuse light from the back that actually increases the contrast and you can see much clearly with the backlight on. Now, I'm coming to the last few slides on tips on eye care. We have something called the 20-20-20 rule, three 20s. First 20 is for 20 minutes, second 20 is for a 20-second break, and the third 20 is to look at an object 20 feet away. What basically this says is that when you are using computers, mobile, or TV for a long time, take a break of at least 20 seconds by looking at an object that is at least 20 feet away. Very simple trick. Or if you want to tell your children, you can modify it a little for our circumstances with online classes. Every half an hour, take a break for 1 minute. If your child is having class, after half an hour, ask them to get up, walk around, maybe even drink a glass of water. If they want to take a toilet break, let them take a toilet break. What one thing you need to remember is when children are missing their school needs, when they have a slight delay, they want to use time. So to avoid that, I see there's a chat message. Okay. Let me just close the chat. Yes. So every 30 minutes, take a break for a minute so that the child during this break period does not chat on the computer phone or does a video game and is constantly under strain. So during the break between the classes, he can walk, take a water, take a drink break, or go to the toilet, or just play around with his parents. And this is a way, and this is a very, very important slide. Now we all know, we are all afraid of Corona, we are afraid of COVID, we are not going out. But it is very essential that adults, children, everybody, get at least 30 minute exposure to sunlight to make sure that we get enough adequate vitamin D3 forming in our body. And also it has got a very good beneficial effect on our stress levels, on our emotional well-being, on our hormone levels. It's very sad to see that there are almost 66 suicides of children during this COVID lockdown. People are depressed. People are staying at home. It is like the Big Box episode. People are not happy. So they need to take a break. They need to go out. They need to go out in the sunlight for a little while at least. So make sure at a time when the sun is not very hot, maybe between 7 o'clock to 8:30 or evening 4 to 5:36, children and parents get a little sunlight exposure, even adults. And one good thing about sunlight is that for children who wear specs, there are some studies that show that exposure to sunlight can actually prevent myopia from progressing. So people who, for children who wear glasses, sunlight is even proven in some studies to prevent progression. So you can make sure that they get adequate sunlight exposure. Now, when you talk about children and specs, this is one question that always comes to me. Doctor, if my child starts wearing specs, will the power keep increasing? Doctor, എൻ്റെ മോൻ മോൾ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ കണ്ണാടി വെച്ച് തുടങ്ങിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ എൻ്റെ മോളുടെ കണ്ണാടി പവർ ഇങ്ങനെ കൂടി 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 വരും. ബിക്കോസ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് ഫ്രൈറ്റ്, സം പീപ്പിൾ, സം പേരൻസ് ഡു നോട്ട് ഈവൻ അലൗ ദർ ഗേൾ ചൈൽഡ് തിങ്കിങ് അബൌട്ട് മാരേജ് ഇൻ ദ ഫ്യൂച്ചർ ടു ഗെറ്റ് ടു വെയർ ടു സ്റ്റാർട്ട് വെയറിംഗ് സ്പെക്സ്. നൗ ഇറ്റ്സ് വെരി സിമ്പിൾ. വി വെയർ സ്പെക്സ് വെൻ ദ ലൈറ്റ് കനോട്ട് ബി ഫോക്കസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ദ റെറ്റിന. ദർ കൻ ബി ത്രീ ഇഷ്യൂസ് ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ. First is myopia. In myopia, people can see near, but they cannot see distance. In this case, the eyeball is a little bigger than normal. In hypermetropia long sight, the eyeball is a little shorter than normal. And in astigmatism, the front curvature of the eye is very... I just got a structure of the eye to show you. If the length of the eye, this is the eyeball structure, if the length of the eye is longer than normal, the child has myopia. Obviously, when a small child, maybe at 6 years, as I showed you, is having minus 0.5 power, as she grows taller, because the eye increases in length, the power keeps increasing from minus 0.5, 1.5, 3, 4.5. That has nothing to do with wearing specs. Irrespective of whether she wears specs or not, as the child grows older, minus power will keep increasing, plus power will keep decreasing. So there is nothing to be concerned or worried about a child wearing specs. Wearing specs will not increase the power. It is just like having an umbrella in the rainy season. If you wear an umbrella, rain does not hit you, you don't get wet. But even if you hold an umbrella for 10 years, if you remove it, you still get wet. It's just like that. When you wear specs, you get clear vision. If you don't wear specs, then the vision is blurred. Now, one more thing that all parents need to be aware about is something called amblyopia. That means if a child wearing specs does not wear specs, clear images do not reach the brain and the brain and the eye do not develop well. And if the child does not wear specs as a child, the child might not have very good vision even when she becomes an adult. That is called amblyopia or lazy eye. That is something that we need to be very careful about. Children requiring specs need to wear specs. It is not optional. So ensure that if your child has specs, ensure that he or she. Now, this is another question that an ophthalmologist usually asked. First was, when you buy a specs, whether you need an anti-reflection coating. The second question many people do ask is, do I need a blue light filter on my lens? Now, we all know a blue light is believed to be protective. So anybody who has got a new mobile, when they look at the options, it gives an option of what a blue light filter. Now, do you need to activate blue light filter on your tablet, on your mobile, on your computer? Do you need to have a glass with blue light filter on? So let me briefly tell you about blue light. Blue light, the sunlight has got different colors, but still the sky is blue. The sky is blue because the blue light disperses fast and it gives a blue color to the sky. Because the blue light disperses fast, if you cut blue light, the clarity of vision increases. That is the first thing. Second thing is, blue light is of higher energy. And so some studies have shown that it can predispose to age-related night vision. Just a few studies, this is not very authentic information. So if you have a glass with blue light filter, well and good, but did not worry, even if your glass does not have blue light filter. One advantage about blue light is that if you cut blue light, it is believed that the sleep quality becomes better. So maybe after 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock, you can activate the blue light filter on your computer or your laptop or your mobile and see if your sleep is better. If it is better, leave it on. If it doesn't make a difference, then just forget about it. It is no big deal. If you have it, well and good. If you don't use it, nothing to worry about. Now, this is one slide about computer vision syndrome. This is one slide I think you could all give a good look at, because this is how you basically need to ensure that your computer is adjusted. If you look at this picture, we will start from the bottom. Your feet should be on the ground, well rested. It should not be hanging from the chair. Your knee joint should be approximately at 90 degrees. Your back joint should be at around 90 degrees and your back should be stable, don't slouch. And your computer screen should be a little below your eye level. Now, if your computer is up, you need to look up. If you look at my eye, when I look up, my eye is more exposed to the atmosphere. While if I look down, my upper lid covers the eye. So that gives a protective effect. So ensure your seat is comfortable, your feet reaches the ground, your knee joint is at 90 degrees, your back is at 90 degrees, your back is straight, your computer screen is below the eye level, and the keyboard should also be comfortable. These are just a few slides on ophthalmology. When you come to me for an eye checkup, I used to do a direct ophthalmoscope wherein I need to go close to the patient. Now, as we know, this is strict, no, during COVID, because I can transmit it to you or you could transmit it to me. So we don't look at a direct ophthalmoscope anymore. We do instrumentation from far now. That is an indirect ophthalmoscope, or we can use a slit lamp microscope. A slit lamp is I think after this talk, I can show you my OP. A slit lamp, we can see from far. Also, we have all these equipments that take a fundus photo, that's the image of the retina from far. The doctor does not need to go to near the patient. When you look at the eye, this is the picture of the eye. What you see inside is the retina. So we see inside the eye using a retinoscope. Now, the importance of looking at the retina is because an ophthalmologist, an eye doctor, is the only doctor who is directly able to see a blood vessel with his naked eye. Like when I look into a patient's eye, I am directly looking at the patient's blood vessel. And if the patient is having elevated blood pressure, I can see the change. If the patient is having elevated diabetes and the blood is leaking fluids inside the eye, I can directly see it. So an ophthalmologist is a doctor who can directly visualize the retina. He can see the blood vessels and then he can give a pointer to the cardiologist, to the physician, to the diabetologist, to the nephrologist on the condition of the blood vessels. And all these specialists depend upon the ophthalmologist to fine tune their treatment. That is why even during these COVID times, we insist that eye checkup should be done at routine intervals to ensure that the good sight we enjoy is maintained throughout their life I'm coming to the end of my presentation. We'll be having just one or two slides on warning signs so that they can be aware when you should immediately see an ophthalmologist. Now, the maximum number of surgeries done anywhere in the world is a cataract surgery. That is the kind of volume that a cataract surgery has. Now, when the COVID lockout started, cataract surgery came down to zero all over India. That is in March, after March 23rd, I believe, no cataract surgeries were done except for emergency throughout India. So the cataract backlog is increasing all over India. We started doing cataracts in June. And just to reassure you, these are the protocols that is given by All India Ophthalmic Society, which is the parent body of ophthalmologists in India, and American Association of Ophthalmology, American Academy of Ophthalmology, which is the parent association of ophthalmologists in the US. So we routinely in Kerala, we do a COVID test before cataract surgery. Because it is done under local anesthesia, that means the general anesthesia is not done, the chance for transmitting corona is very less. Aerosols are not produced during cataract surgery, so it is safe. The patient wears a mask, the doctor wears a mask on top, we have a face shield also, that prevents transmission during the surgery. So when you consider having a surgery done, just remember whether you have got these insurances, whether you are covered by CGHS, ECHS, or star or private insurance, or you are part of the Pradhan Mantri Bima Yojana, because all these may facilitate treatment during this time. Now, these are our last few slides. This is a very important slide. Now, if you look at what is written in yellow, please take a second to read that. 80% of blindness is preventable or treatable. I think this is the reason I am doing this talk for this elite audience. We got 100 plus participants now. I told a lot more people will be seeing it on YouTube and the recorded media. Now, this is the most important point that I would like you to remember. 80% of blindness is preventable or treatable, or in other words, almost 3 out of 4 blind people in this world are unnecessarily blind. Their blindness could have been treated or prevented. So this talk is totally dedicated to this message on preserving vision. Now, many people have this thought, my sight is perfect. Why should I go and meet an eye doctor? എനിക്ക് എല്ലാം നല്ലതുപോലെ കാണാം. എന്തിനാ ഞാൻ ഒരു ഡോക്ടറിനെ കാണണം? The reason is very simple. It is on the slide to your left. That shows the structure of the eye, and that the part marked in red is called the macula. It is just 10%. It is just 10% of the eye. And if this 10%, if you look at the structure, the bottom part, it is just 10%. It's a very small part of the eye. If that is for functioning, you will have very good vision, and you might not know. But if the periphery is having a problem, it can affect the central part in certain cases in minutes, sometimes in weeks, sometimes in months. But an eye doctor, by looking inside the eye, might be able to pick up very, very early signs and prevent somebody from going blind if we are able to pick it up early. That is why when I gave the key points, take-home messages, I said, even if you have perfect sight, you still need to do a routine eye checkup so that this perfect vision is throughout your life. So when do you need to do a routine eye checkup? For everybody more than 40, please get an eye checkup done once in 3 years. It can be at any eye specialist. All of us are equipped to have a look at the eye. If you are diabetic, get an eye checkup done once a year. If you are more than 60, get an eye checkup done once a year, because after 60, chance of developing age-related macular degeneration is more. So these are the key important points, and these are the warning signs. So ideally, you need to show a doctor before anything bad happens. But if something bad happens, then you should not wait anymore. The big three, you know, if you have a loss of sight, immediately show the doctor. If you have pain or redness, immediately show the doctor. On top of that, the other signs are, if your eye goes crossed, if one eye goes to the left, that can be a sign of stroke. If you have a stroke, you have to treat as early as possible, because if you see an immunologist within 24 hours, they might be able to thrombolyze you and get very good vision back for you. If you have difficulty in closing your eyes, that can again be a stroke. So immediately show a doctor. If you see a dark spot in front of your eye, when you look at something, you cannot see that particular part clear, or that is distorted. If you look at the door, instead of looking like a straight line, if it is curved, then immediately you need to show an eye doctor. If you have got watering, pain, discharge, if you have difficulty in looking at light, if you look at the light, if you see glare, then you need to immediately show a doctor. If you feel that something like a curtain is coming in front of your eye, that can be retinal detachment, immediately show a doctor. If you have trouble adjusting to a dark room, immediately again show a doctor. Or if you have a very crooked appearance, you should see a doctor. But the take-home message is, you should not wait for any of these to develop. If you are normal, if you are perfect sight, once in 3 years, between 40 and 60 years, please show an eye specialist. After 60, see a doctor once a year. Now, during this COVID times, a lot of people call me. They are scared to go to a doctor. They are scared to go to an eye specialist. They are scared to go to a hospital. So what can you do? Now, I told you the warning signs. Pain, redness, defectivation, immediately you need to show a doctor. Also, the previous, the other points also that I said, crossed eyes, double vision, inability to close your eyes, go and see a doctor. But if your complaints are vague, that you have a slight redness, it is not affecting your vision, you have got maybe slightly blurred vision sometimes, you got a swelling on there which you think might be a sty, you got a redness at a corner of the eye, you got itching, you got slight watering, all these things, even if you are scared to see a doctor in person, you can depend on any of these online apps. I don't think I should be taking any names, but I'm sorry I put some slides on. Even our hospital has started online consultation. We initially started as a free consultation for NORCA routes as instructed by IME and by the Chief Minister. I was on the panel for giving free consultation to the patients from Saudi. I got even calls from the US. So we were giving free consultation at that time. Now that the people are able to move out, if they still are scared to come to the hospital, they can depend on online platforms to get an eye checkup done. And this is a simple thing. I think this is one of the last few slides. This is a simple thing that you can check your eye at home. This is called an Amsler grid, AMSLER, Amsler grid. You can download this from the net. It is basically crosshairs. You have a central dark spot. What you need to do is you need to close one eye and look at the dark spot. When you keep looking at the dark spot, if you see any wavy lines by the side, that is a warning sign that your eye is going bad. You need to immediately show the doctor. Another thing you remember to need to do is close one eye, close the other eye, and check both eyes separately. So this is a simple test that you can do to do. And this is the slide that I always, this is what I always tell my patient. Never, never, ever lose hope. COVID will end. Vaccine will come. Even if no vaccine comes, we will still survive. We have survived floods. We have survived. We will survive an earthquake at Latu. We will survive COVID also. So whatever happens, never lose faith. Even in conditions where you think that nothing more can be done, we might still be able to salvage your sight. So try to see a doctor before anything goes bad. If something goes bad, try to see him immediately. And even if you think seem beyond control, still the situation might be salvageable. So please. And that actually completes my talk. I have stayed within my allotted time. And this is the last slide. And this is a feel-good slide on how to look good during a Zoom call. I think you will find this interesting. Now, if you look at a person, my own daughter, if she takes a selfie, she takes a selfie like this. She holds it. Can you hear me? So she takes a selfie like this. So what happens is when you hold the camera above your head, your face appears slim, as can be seen in the photo at the bottom. Your face is slim when the camera is held at the top. So always make sure your camera is not down. Now if I stand up, and then I shoot like this. See the distortion that is happening in my face? My face is like this. that does not look very good. Double chin, wrinkles, everything is more prominent. So you need, that is one tip. Second tip is wear clothes, light colored clothes, not pure white or pure black. Facial sheets do good, and make it without any fussy patterns. Make sure lighting is good. So if your light is bad, then as you can see, this does not convey the image well. You cannot see my expression. So make sure that your light is good. The light should be coming from front of you. Make sure that what is behind, you don't have a bright screen behind. If you look at the lady standing in front of a bright window, so if you want to shoot in front of a bright window to show your exterior, make sure you got adequate light on your face so that it counterbalances and you are able to see very well. So tip number one, maintain good light, wear clean clothes without too many patterns. Make sure your camera is at eye level. If it is very low, then you look more old. And don't go too close to the camera. If I go too close to the camera, as you can see, my face gets distorted. So maintain adequate distance from the camera. So with all these, we should look good. Indians always look good. So that should not be a problem. And this is just a fun slide I kept at the end. I hope you like my presentation. And I'm signing off with this last slide, which is my passion. I love doing scuba diving. This is me snorkeling with my daughter. And that's the tortoise I shot in the Maldives Sea. And what you see on the left side is the world's first glaucoma awareness dive, wherein me and my 20 scuba diving friends, we dived down and unfurled the glaucoma awareness banner to create awareness about glaucoma. Thank you. I hope I've stayed within my time, and I hope you found my presentation useful. I'll stop my slide share now, and I hand it over to our compere for any questions. I have not checked the chat till now. I'll just see if...
Well, I'll help you, doctor. That was really a wonderful session. And yes, the last few slides, you just really made us look it right. Thank you so much for those cute tips. And yes, scuba diving. I just wonder how you could do all that with the banner also there. Great. Now, coming back to the questions, Ms. Shyamala Shashidharan has requested. So that through, you have said that by viewing our eyes, you get a clue to our serious health issues. So any more tips on to that?
Dr. Shyamala Shashidharan is my chitamma. Lovely to have her here. She is a linguistics professor known all over the world for her excellent books on linguistics, which I think believe is a Bible for a lot of students. Now, what happens is if you look at my eye, the central dark spot is called the pupil. Just like the eye, it lets a light enter inside. When I look at the eye with an ophthalmoscope, I am able to directly visualize what is there inside the eye. So the blood vessels inside the eye come under the category middle-sized blood vessels. Now, if you look at my wrist, you are able to see slightly, you can see the blue veins. So these sides of veins that are there inside my eye, I can see the blood vessel. And if unfortunately you are having cholesterol, many of us know cholesterol gets deposited in the blood vessels. Now, when I look directly at the blood vessel, I might be even able to see a plaque on the blood vessel. Now here we got an artery that is called the carotid artery. If the carotid artery has got cholesterol crystals, sometimes they break off, they enter the carotid artery, they enter the blood vessels, go through these blood vessels, go inside the eye and block a part that is called retinal vein occlusion. Now, if they block the brain, that causes a stroke. If they block the heart blood vessel, it causes a heart attack. Now, if you have a heart attack, an angiogram is done to look where the block is. If you have a stroke, a CT is done to see where the block is. An ophthalmologist looks in the eye and sees it directly. Sometimes I am able to see the cholesterol that is actually blocking the vessel. It's a sad thing. one of my uncle's neighbor, he came to me. I diagnosed that there is a cholesterol crystal in your eye. It can, you know, if another crystal breaks and goes to the brain, you might have a stroke. So immediately I referred him to a cardiologist. He got admitted in one of the famous hospitals here. Unfortunately, while admitted, 2 days after I diagnosed him, he had a stroke and they could not revive him. So that's why I said an ophthalmologist is the only specialist who can directly see the eye, and we might be able to pick up cholesterol crystals, that is hypercholesterolemia. We might be able to pick up hypertension that is not under control, that might be papilledema, grade 4 hypertension. We might be able to pick up diabetic retinopathy. And in my career, I have picked up 5 brain tumors by just looking at the fundus. Now the brain is directly connected to the eye. The brain's nerve is a direct continuation of the eye nerve is a direct continuation of the brain. So when you look directly at the eye, normally this part of the brain of the eye should be here. If you look at it, this part of the eye should be red in color. Now if there is a pressure on the nerve, it can turn white. That is called an optic atrophy. And looking at the optic nerve, we might be able to diagnose brain tumor. Recently, just a year back, one of my classmates' wife, she was having headache for a long duration. They were in Kochi, they came over to see me. Luckily, I was able to pick it up and they got operated at Aster 2 week following. She's doing extremely well now. So that's why I said, even if you don't have any problems, you still need to get your routine checkups done, because even a stroke, even a heart attack, we might be able to prevent by just looking at the eye. And thank you, Chitima, for that excellent question.
Thank you so much for elaborating further on the importance of getting those routine checks so that we can be on the right track with good health. And there's one question here from Ms. Shubha, that if a mobile screen is looked at for half an hour, it actually strains the eyes and it becomes very difficult to read from a paper. Is it because of the strain caused to the eyes, or is it a problem which has developed in the eyes?
Now, because it's an excellent question, please give me 1 minute to answer it. To answer that question, I will need to tell you how the eye functions. Inside the eye, there is a muscle that is called the ciliary muscle. This muscle inside the eye acts upon our lens and changes its power. When we look at distant objects, this muscle is at rest. It does not need to work. When we look at near objects, this muscle needs to constrict so that we are able to see near objects. That much is clear, right? So when we look at near objects for a long time, this muscle can get tired, especially if you're older than 40. Nammalellam ketunda velleyutha, in English it's called presbyopia. Nearing 40, we need to use glasses to read. That is because the ciliary muscle is not able to focus near for a long time. That is why we start using near vision glasses after 40. The first point is, we have a muscle called ciliary muscle that is used for near. Second point is that after 40, this muscle gets tired and we need to supplement it with a glass to read. Third point is, for people with hypermetropia or long sight, this muscle has to act even at rest for distance to get clear vision. Now with these 3 points, I'll answer your question. If a person with hypermetropia, long sight, uses mobile phone a long time without glasses, he'll get eye strain. Second point, if a person more than 40 who has presbyopia due to age uses mobile phone for a long time without glasses, he'll get headache. Now if that person above 40 also has got hypermetropia, then the headache will be all the more because he has got hypermetropia, which requires the ciliary muscle to act. He has got presbyopia, which again causes it to act. So if you have headache after half an hour of viewing, you might need glasses. Please see an ophthalmologist to check your power to ensure that the power is corrected. If a child is having headache after watching mobile phone for half an hour. That is not what we expect. A child should be able to watch it for 3-4 hours without getting a headache. If he gets headache, it is likely he has got hypermetropia, so you need to get an eye checkup done. I need to clarify one more point, because some children might be happy hearing me say that they can watch for 1 hour. Thing is, after half an hour, you need to take a break. Don't, like, I have got children who spend 4, 5, 6 hours on PUBG. They don't know time going. So after half an hour, please take a break. Don't see mobile phone continuous. It's not good for the eye. It does not harm the eye, but it can harm you emotionally. And, you know, you your social well-being, everything gets in big stress. So after half an hour, please take a break. And to madam, to answer your question, get your eyes checked. If you have got hypermetropia or you are more than 40, please use glasses while watching mobile or a laptop. Right now.
Something connected to that, there's one more question. Mr. Faya says, I'm using computer for more than 12 hours a day. I noticed some anomaly in my vision as the days progressed. The anomaly was I wasn't able to focus on things far away, which I was able to do before lockdown. Should I consult a doctor?
Madam, let me give broad guidelines, because we still got 100 plus audience now watching from all over the world. For children, first checkup is required at 5 years of age. Next checkup ideally at 10 years, then 20 years, then around 40 years. After 40, once in 3 years. After 60, once a year. If you are diabetic, compulsorily every year. So if you have difficulty after watching for 1 or 2 hours, please see an eye doctor. Get your eyes checked. It might be something very small, like glasses, which can be corrected. It might be something more difficult to treat, like a glaucoma. That can also cause defective near vision and blurring. So ensure that you have got none of these, so that you can see clearly even when you are 80, 90, 100 plus. Thank you.
That's great. Just one more question before we close that. Is it useful to use computer glass for the person who uses laptop more? That's some shield sort of?
Yeah, I'll answer it in a very simple way.
Yeah.
The reason we use computer glasses is to prevent reflection from happening from the lens. So if you don't need glasses at all, what is the point in having a glass? And then creating reflections and then canceling it. The only advantage of wearing a glass is that it prevents wind from blowing and drying out your eyes. If there's any dust, it prevents that from coming into your eyes. If you don't have glasses, using a computer glass or any glass for that matter, while using computer, does not in any way help you. If you have a power, if you need glasses, get a glass done with anti-reflection coating if you can afford to. That even that is not compulsory. If you can afford to, an anti-reflection glasses definitely will give you much clearer vision than a glass without anti-reflection coating. But if you don't have any power, it's not necessary for you to go buy an anti-reflection glass.
Thank you so much, sir. I think now we'll come to the end of the session, and you can see in the chat box that everybody is very appreciative and very thankful for the excellent and very informative session that you gave us, sir. And now I invite Professor Shabirina to deliver the vote of thanks. Professor Shabirina, you are on mute, sir. Professor Shabirina. Kindly. I'll request Professor Shabirina to deliver the vote of thanks. Thank you, Dr. Devin, for that excellent presentation and very, very informative tips for all of us, which is indeed, yes, eyes is most important. I mean, of course, all parts of a body are important, but eyes has a special thing for all of us. So thank you so much for giving us all the tips to safeguard ourselves. And I thank all the participating organizations also for coming together and then continuing this weekly webinar series for the, this is the 22nd session. Thank you so much for all the leaders and dear participants. Yes, it was, you all have more than 100 were there actively here, and of course from all the different parts of the country. Thank you so much for your participation, and we'll have continue with this webinar series next year, next week too, and on the same Wednesday on 6 o'clock, and the topic will be on technology based asset integrity solutions by Sengodan Vasudevan, the director, Deva Preservation Services Private Limited, Singapore. So I request everybody to kindly join in next Wednesday at the same time, 6 o'clock, for the 23rd session of our weekly webinar. Thank you all. Thank you.